be his good friend. Please welcome Mr. Dennis Cook.
Hi, my name is Dennis Cook, and I graduated here in 1971. Jim's not only my friend, but he's my brother-in-law, so it's a double pleasure. It's kind of weird to be here again. It makes me feel kind of old after all these years, but I see my former coach, Ted Snap, back there, and he looks so good. If he looks that good, I can't be that bad. Thanks, Ted, for setting the world right for me again. I'm not that old. But several months ago, the phone rang, and I picked it up, and it says, "Hello, this is Mike Cox from the Arcata High Hall of Fame Nominating Committee." And I'm like, "Yeah, right." They finally got me, you know? And so instantly, I can see parades and honors and pictures on the wall, you know? And just as I was getting ready to say, "Yeah, I accept, you know? Let's get a parade going." He says, "Can you get me in touch with your brother-in-law, Jim Titera? He's nominated for the Hall of Fame." Well, so there was an instant wave of disappointment that I felt, but obviously I realized Jim deserves this and not me. And here's why tonight. I'm going to give you some of his accolades that he has done here at school and in life both. And so, in 1966, he came here as a freshman, transfer in the middle of the year, so he didn't get to play any sports his freshman year. But in his sophomore year, he ran both cross country and track. And when he turned junior and got on the varsity, he set a new league record in the cross country. And in track, he qualified for the state track meet in Berkeley in both the 880 and the mile, in both events. And he was so stoked to go that he went to the state meet instead of going to his junior-senior prom. He stood up his future wife-to-be so that he could go to the state track meet. Guy's got his priorities right together, man. And of course, he was all-county in cross-country and track in his junior year. He set the county school record for the 880, and it stood for years. Nobody really broke it. We were talking to former coach Snap a little bit ago, and the gentleman who broke it ran the 800 meters. They no longer run the yards, and so you got to do the math and figure it out and everything. And he beat Jim's record not that long ago. It stood for years, but with the new math nowadays, you know, you never can be sure. I'm thinking maybe Jim still might own this record. Somebody needs to double check. Also, as a senior, he was all county in track. That's a pretty impressive list. But here's the rest of the story on Jim. He once he graduated, he started UC Davis in the fall of 1969. In 1970, he married his high school sweetheart. His wife, Sue Dorman, is the daughter of the late Bill Dorman, who taught math here for years and years. I bet if I asked for a raise of hands, and everybody that was here probably remembers Bill Dorman. They've been married for 45 years. They have three sons who are here tonight to watch this. They came from all over, from Colorado and Southern California. And he has two granddaughters. They're also in attendance here tonight. So that's quite an honor. But back in 1970, Jim and Sue moved to San Diego and still calls it his home to this day. In 1975, he graduated from San Diego State with a BS in marketing. Jim's always been good at BS. Still is. But, you know, going in to school like that on his own with a wife and a new baby, I admire him for that. And he put that to good use. He's owned a 7-Eleven for 29 years, and he's retiring next month. So that's well deserved. But in the communion, Jim's not just all sports ability and business savvy. He's also involved in the community there. And as a younger man here, he earned the rank of a Eagle Scout, which is a really admirable thing to do while he was going to school. He served 2 years on the student council here at Arcata High. He was on the Pepperbox staff, was in the Key Club, and also the president of the Varsity Club. And as an adult in San Diego, he coached his son's baseball teams for 18 years. He's an avid golfer, and he served on the board of directors for his men's club. He's also on the board of directors for the Franchise Owners Association for the business. And Jim's been not only my brother-in-law, but my friend, as I said, we're close. And there's a wonderful saying that goes, you're not successful unless you have a successful successor. And I've always liked that. And Jim has been a faithful husband. He's raised three successful boys, and they're raising successful grandkids. So I think his life has been very fruitful and successful. Doesn't happen by accident. You got to work at it, Jim. You've done good. He's been a good employer through the years for many people at 7-Eleven. He's been part boss, part father and mentor to a lot of people that needed help. He's gone over and above on the wonderful things he's done. And he's a kind man and a nice man in both the family and the community. He's a good man. And this award is a great honor to Jim, but his true legacy is not just going to be a picture on the wall, but it's a passing of the good morals and just living to the future generations. So please welcome a really cool guy, Jim Titera.
Honored that they all decided to make this trip up here. I do have to take this honor in perspective, and that this was basically for 2 years, short years out of my life. And at first, I really didn't think much of, boy, is that a big deal, Yeah, I ran track cross country, and all I did was run around on some dirt and mud, slid down hills and ran on an asphalt track, and it amounted to something. It basically set the tone for the rest of my life. I guess what made me good in track was I was persistent, and according to my family, I like to be in control. I always want to be first. Now, with all my sons and their wives now, I've learned I have to take a back seat because I got three, or at least two out of three, that are very, very controlling. I did come to Arcata High School in the middle of my high school freshman year. I came from Whittier, California. And when I went to school, we pretty much dressed like this. Wingtips, slacks, button-down shirts. Came to Arcata, blue jeans, tennis shoes, t-shirts, flat flannel shirts. So it was a little shock for me. But I soon discovered, and I think it was probably from my PE experience in the end of my freshman year, that either probably Coach Jerry Paul and Ted Snapp encouraged me to, go out for cross country the next year. And I took it up as a sophomore and liked it, was fairly good at it, and then that's what continued on, and I did very well after that. I just always wanted to be first. During my sophomore year, I saw this platinum blonde girl, and I pursued her. Smiling back by the time we were a junior, we were going steady, and I knew that was going to be my wife. Sorry, kind of choking me up there. During the junior year, I really thought I was hot stuff. As Dennis said, set a cross country record, set the 880 record, and you're going to state track meet. Well, I did set personal best in both the 880 and my mile run at the state track meet in Cal Berkeley. However, in the 880, I was 13th. There's a lot of people in front of you, and they really go fast. And I was amazed. We ran our split in that 880, and it was as fast as what they were running the 440 up here in just a half of a race. So it did kind of wake me up to, hey, you really got to be good. You're not the very best, but you just do your best, and that's what I strive to do. I had to write down stuff real fast because I agonized over this. Tanya would know that I went through every detail, and I had sleepless nights. What am I going to say? And I came up with all these thoughts, and I never wrote them down, so I'd already forgot half of them. So you guys are lucky. what high school did, it set the tone for my life. My wife, Sue, did most of the raising of our three sons because I was going to school full-time and working full-time. Started out at Safeway, and that was 6 days a week. So I was able to participate in the sports, and finally by the time the third one came around, I did a lot more participation, but basically a little bit of help in soccer, but coaching the baseball, which I did. All my boys were in sports. Michael, he was in youth soccer and baseball. Todd, my middle son, he was also in the same thing, soccer and baseball, but then he played club soccer, and as a 14 and under team, they won the state championship, which was a real honor. He also played high school soccer, and he ran track. And then Josh, he also was the same soccer and baseball growing up, and then he was he played high school baseball and football, and then he played junior college baseball. So, in conclusion, high school sports helped set me in the right direction for the rest of my life. And I really didn't realize it until I went back through all these events. So I humbly accept this honor, and I thank you guys for taking me through memory lane.
Folks, as a token here, we have a Arcata baseball hat and a plaque that will be, it will have a secondary plaque that will be mounted on our wall in our entrance.
Arcata High Gymnasium, three inductions were made into the Sports Hall of Fame. The 19th year that individual alumni or teams have been recognized for exceptional excellence. Please welcome, from the class of 1969, Jim Titera. Jim set the Delmar League record in cross country and track, as well as winning multiple county awards. He excelled in the state meet in Berkeley, California. Following high school, Jim attended UC Davis and the San Diego State University. Please welcome Jim Titera.